Hi, this is Topher with Simply Schedule Appointments. This video is intended for fitness trainers, and I want to show you how you can implement Simply Schedule Appointments into your websites so that people can create appointments with you for workout sessions. Let me show you what it looks like on the front end before we get started. Here we have three different types of sessions: introductory, individual, and group. Introductory sessions are 30 minutes and don't cost anything. People can choose their day and their time. Then we're also going to look at individual sessions, which cost $50 and require people to pay and have an hour time. And lastly, group sessions, which are limited in capacity so that your groups don't get too large. Let's take a look at how those are set up. This is the admin area for Simply Schedule Appointments, and we're under Appointment Types, and these are the three that you saw up front. Let's take a look at what an introductory session looks like. This is the name that gets printed on the front of this website, and here's our time, how long it can be. The label is only for the back end, so it doesn't matter so much what you choose. The slug also doesn't really matter too much what you use. The end user will never see it. And then you can show the booking layout is either weekly or monthly. What you saw a moment ago was weekly for all of them, but we're going to switch one to monthly, and I'll show you what it looks like there. And then there's the instructions. Now, briefly, I want to go over the rest of the settings with you. When are you available for this type of appointment? Right now, it is 9 to 4, Monday through Sunday. Now, let's say you don't want to work on Sundays. So with these colored blocks, you can click them one at a time, or you can click and drag and change a whole bunch of them at once. And let's say you only work on weekdays. There. Now you work 9 to 4. Monday through Friday. Then we can also have an availability window, so a date range. So say you want to offer this appointment type only in the summer. So it could be June through August. You could put in June 1 through August 31st or something. So the next option is capacity. How many customers at a time? And this is a single person time. This is an introduction to a person to find out their needs, things like that. So we leave it at one. Scheduling options. There's localized and locked. Localized means that they will see the times in their own time zone. And this is great for phone calls and online meetings. Now, as a fitness trainer, if you're doing them online, which people do now that Corona has come, then you might want to leave it at localized. But if the times are for your gym, you probably want to set them to locked, and you can choose your time zone. Now, if I click edit here, it's going to leave this page, and I'll lose my settings. So I'm going to save real quick, show you how to change the time zone, and come back to it. So scheduling options, click it, and it goes to the settings area for Simply Schedule Appointments. And you can choose, I'm in the Eastern time zone, so I choose Detroit. Now let's save. And we'll go back to our appointment types. And you can see right there now, my time zone is America, Detroit. Now, again, you'll want to choose localized if you're doing it online. You probably want locked if you're doing it at a physical location. Then how much time should be left free before and after an appointment? Again, this varies. If it's in a physical location, you might want 10 minutes between or 20 minutes. If it's on the phone and you don't have them stacked back to back, 1 minute is fine. But this is entirely up to you. And so there's before and after. And then how much notice do you need when someone books an appointment? You want 3 hours. You don't want them to book an appointment for 5 minutes from now. And then in advance, you don't want, if it's July, you don't want people scheduling appointments for January because that's just too far out. Or maybe it's not. That's up to you. You can set that here. And then we have here the booking window, a specific date range when customers will have access to book this type of appointment. So again, maybe this is a summertime one. And then you can also choose how many per day. So say you have 8 hour blocks, 8 individual hour blocks set up, but you don't want 8 of them. Maybe you only want 4 or 6. You can set that limit here as well. Now for payments, this is the introductory one, so no payment required. Easy enough. You can optionally have this set up to sync with your Google Calendar. If this is an online workout session, you can set up a URL for it or not. You can optionally require some customer information. And there are a wide variety of field types here. So you could ask questions like age, weight, experience, things like that. And then notifications. Who's going to get emailed when an appointment is created? So that's it for the introductory session. For individual session, I'm really only going to show you what's different. For this one, it's still weekly. There's a different color, but that doesn't matter. The only thing that's different with this one is payments. Now, there's another video on how to set up payments, so I'm not going to go through it all here with you. But this gives you the ability to set how much something costs and the ability to collect the payment from them at the time of booking. So that's really slick. Now, there's one more type, and it's a bit unique. So let me show you how that works. So this is the group session. And for the others, you are allowing people to choose any of a given hour in a day. So there's like 40 hours they could choose from. But with group sessions, you need to plan them out better. So maybe 7 p.m. every day, you have your group session. And you want to limit how many people can come to a given session based on your gym size. So we write in the instructions up to 5 people per group. Then for availability, we want to switch from available blocks to specific start times. And then we want it 7 p.m. So we'll click the first one here and hold shift and click this one over here and turn all of those off. And these extra lines will go away when you save. Now, I actually did it wrong. I don't want 8, I want 7. So I want to point out that you can click hours here and it will choose that row. So let's say you don't want to work Sunday, but maybe you want to work twice on Saturday because people have the day off during Saturday. And our sessions are every 60 minutes. Now, the rest of this is the same, but now we're going to go to capacity and set it to 5. You can see our options here are individual and group. So now that's 5. Now let me make sure under basics, I set, yeah, okay. So we want to switch this to monthly. So now I'm going to save. We'll go back to the front of the site and reload. So for comparison, I'm going to open up individual. And you could choose a day off this list. Now I'm going to choose group, and there's a calendar, and you can say, I want to come on Tuesday the 16th, and it simply asks you to pay and confirm. But if you choose Saturday the 20th, then you have to choose between afternoon and evening, and clicking one of these does the same as the other. It brings up the payment window. So that's all there is to it, to setting up a personal training session calendar where people can sign up to come work out with you. We looked at a free introductory session, we looked at a paid individual session, and we looked at group sessions, and we looked at several different calendar types. It's really flexible. As you can see, it looks beautiful. It matches the design of your site. So I hope you're able to use this to set up some great workout sessions.